Hello friends, today I am going to start the second unit of Engineering Maths 2, that is Differential Calculus. Differential Calculus or Differentiation. Differential Calculus. Now, what is meant by differential calculus? First, let us see what is differential calculus. Now, suppose I have an equation y is equal to log x, something like that. I have an equation y is equal to log x. Now, this is an equation between two variables. The variables are, one variable is y and the other variable is x. They are related by an equation. This is called as an equation in mathematics. Now, if there is a change in the value of x, naturally the value of y also will change. Let us say the value of x increases or decreases by delta x. Its value increases or decreases by delta x. Now, the value of y is dependent on the value of x, or we say y is a function of x. If we write like this, it means y is a function of x. The meaning of this is that the value of y depends upon the value of x. So, if the value of x changes from x to delta x, let us say it becomes x plus delta x. Then what happens is the value of y also will change, and this is y plus delta y. Now, delta x by delta y, limit of this as delta x tends to 0 is known as the derivative of, this is known as the derivative of x, derivative of y with respect to x. Delta y by delta x is called as derivative of x with respect to x, or this is also known as differentiation of x with respect to x, derivative of y with respect to x, or derivative of differentiation of y with respect to x. The symbol for this is dy by dx. If we write like this, it means we are differentiating y with respect to x, where y is a function of x, and the meaning of that is, what will be the limit of delta y by delta x when delta x tends to 0. This is the meaning of differentiation, and the subject we study this, it is called as the differential calculus. Now, here let us see, y is equal to a constant. This is an equation. Y is equal to a constant is an equation, a constant. See, now if the value of x changes, then delta y is 0. It doesn't, because here there is no x in this. If there is no x in that, then there is no change in the value of y. So delta y by delta x, limit of this as delta x approaches 0 will be 0. That means d by dx, differentiation with respect to x of any constant is 0. This is the first thing that you get. Any number, constant means it can be any numerical. If it doesn't contain x, there is no x in this, y is not a function of x, then even though there is a change in x, there is no change in y. So delta d by dx of a constant is always 0. This we have to remember. Then d by dx of x, d by dx of x, this will be 1 always. You remember d by dx of x will be 1. Next, d by dx of x to the power of n will be n x to the power of n minus 1. This they may ask us to prove, that is from first principle derive that d by dx of x to the power of n is equal to x to the power of n minus 1. So we will take up this, we will take up that derivation. So let us say y is equal to x to the power of n. Y is equal to x to the power of n. Then x plus delta x, let us say x value changes by delta x whole to the power of n. If x value changes, there is a change in y also, that is y plus delta y. So delta y will be equal to x plus delta x minus, I am sending this y to the other side, so it becomes minus y. What is y? Y is x plus delta x minus x to the power of n, because y it is given. We have taken y is equal to x to the power of n. So instead of this y, I can write it as x to the power of n. So delta y by delta x, delta y by delta x will be equal to x plus delta x minus x to the power of n divided by delta x, because I have divided this side by delta x, this side also I have divided by delta x. Now limit dy by dx, what I want is differentiation of y with respect to x when y is equal to x to the power of n. So this will be equal to delta limit of delta y by delta x as delta x tends to 0. This is the definition of dy by dx. Dy by dx stands for limit of delta y by delta x as delta x tends to 0. So this will be equal to limit of x plus delta x whole to the power of n minus x to the power of n divided by delta x as delta x tends to 0. Now what I will do is dy by dx is equal to when delta x tends to 0, when delta x tends to 0, what happens is x plus delta x will tend to x, will tend to x. When x plus x tend, delta x tends to 0, when delta x tends to 0, x plus delta x will tend to x, because this will become, this will approach 0, x, the value of this approaches x. So instead of this, what I will do is limit of, instead of delta x approaches 0, I will write delta x, I'll write x plus delta x approaches x. X limit of this x plus delta x to the power of n minus x to the power of n divided by, here what I will do is x plus delta x minus x. What I have done here, I have added one x. Here only delta x is there. I have added one x to it and subtracted one x. So the value doesn't change. They get cancelled. Now, limit of x plus delta x whole to the power of n minus x to the power of n divided by x plus delta x minus x. X plus delta x here. X plus delta x approaches x. Now, this you have already learnt these limits in M1. In the first semester, we have learnt limits. We have learnt limit of x to the power of n minus a to the power of n by x minus a as x tends to a. As x tends to a is equal to n into a to the power of n minus 1. This already we have learned this in limits. So applying that rule here, what we get here is n is n only here into a. A is x here into n minus 1. So dy by dx is equal to n into x to the power of n minus 1 if y is equal to x to the power of n, then dy by dx is equal to n into x to the power of n. Now, for example, in a problem, it comes like this. D by dx of x to the power of 8. Anything, x to the power of something. Now, this will be 8 into x to the power of 8 minus 1. Or 8 into x to the power of 7. N is 8. X to the power of 8 minus 1, n minus 1. So 8 minus 1 is 7. So this will be the answer. Suppose we have d by dx of 3x to the power of 5. Now, this can be written as 3 into d by dx of x to the power of 5. If there is no sign here, this is 3. 3 is the coefficient of this number. There is multiplication there. No plus or minus there. Then you can take it out, x to the power of 5. Now apply this law here. This 3 will remain outside only. The differentiation of this will be 5, x to the power of 5 minus 1. So it will become 15x to the power of 4. So if a coefficient is there here, that coefficient will remain as it is, and we have to differentiate this. This you must understand. This is a monomial. When it is a monomial expression, it will come like this. If there is no this thing here, it means it is 1. 1 into 8 will be 8 only. If there is nothing here, that means the coefficient is 1, then you need not do anything. So this is the differentiation of x to the power of n. Then d by dx of this derivation is called deriving from first principle. They can ask if y is equal to sin x, show that or prove that dy by dx is equal to cos x. This can be from first principles means you have to derive like this. Again, the same thing, you have a few functions, sin x, cos x, tan x, you have to do it. So it is given y is equal to sin x. So sin of x plus delta x, that is an increment is given to x, a small increment is given to x, then let us say there is an increment in y also. Y also gets increased and the amount by which it increases is delta y. So delta y again will be equal to sine of x plus delta x. This y, same procedure what I did last time, the same thing. This y I will transfer that side, keeping only this delta y here. So minus y it becomes. So delta y by delta x now. Divide both sides by delta x. Here sine of x plus delta x minus y can be written as sine x. Instead of y, I can write it as sine x divided by delta x. Next, same way as we did here. Now here, this is now in the form sine A minus sine B. Sine A minus sine B. Sine of A minus sine of B. This can be written as two times sine of A plus B by 2, A minus B by 2. This is, you have done it in trigonometry, A minus B divided by 2, sine of A minus B divided by 2 into cos of A plus B divided by 2. You can use this relationship. This relationship we have studied in M1 in trigonometry, that we have to use here. So applying that, we get delta y by delta x is equal to, instead of this I can write it as 2 into sine of A minus B, sine of x plus delta x minus x. A is x plus delta x, this is this thing, divided by 2 into cos of x plus delta x plus x divided by 2, whole thing divided by delta x. Now this gets cancelled here, this gets cancelled. So what is left there? This two gets cancelled. Sine of delta x into cos of 2x plus delta x divided by 2. Divided by delta x, the pask. Now, limit of delta y by delta x as delta x tends to 0 will be equal to 2 into sine of delta x by 2 divided by delta x by 2 into 2 into 2. I have divided and multiplied by this thing into cos of 2x plus delta x divided by 2. Now this becomes, that is, this is dy by dx, dy by dx is equal to 2 by 2 into limit of sine of delta x by 2 divided by delta x by 2 as delta x tends to 0 into limit of as delta x tends to 0 cos 2x plus delta x divided by 2. Now this becomes 1, limit of this becomes 1. So this is also 1, 1 into 1 is 1 only, into this will be cos of 2x plus 0 divided by 2, that is 2x by 2, that is 2, 2 gets cancelled, so that is equal to cos x. So y is equal, dy by dx is equal to cos x. If this thing y is equal to sin x, if y is equal to sin x, then differentiation of y with respect to x is cos x, that is dy by dx is. So now the remaining one or two of them, if y is equal to cos x, what is dy by dx? If y is equal to tan x, what is? Similarly, from first principle you can get the answer. Now let us take up the standard derivatives. That is, these derivatives we will be using regularly in our problems. See, first one is d by dx, differentiation with respect to x of any constant is 0. This I have told you already. And d by dx of x is 1. Then d by dx of x to the power of n is n into x to the power of n minus 1. If there is a coefficient there, then d by dx of a into x to the power of n is there, then it will be a into n into x to the power of n minus 1. Whatever number is there, that number will be carried there. Then d by dx of trigonometric functions. Now after this you get trigonometric functions. Sin x, we have seen this is equal to cos x. D by dx of cos x is minus sin x. D by dx of tan x is secant square x. Then d by dx of cosecant x will be minus cosecant x cot x. Then d by dx of secant x will be secant x tan x. Then d by dx of cot x will be minus cosecant square x. These are trigonometric functions. Then d by dx of logarithmic function, log x to base e will be 1 by x. Then exponential function, d by dx of e to the power of x will be e to the power of x only. Then if it is d by dx of e to the power of ax, some number, then that will be a into e to the power of ax. Then d by dx of root x will be minus 1 by 2 root x. Then inverse trigonometric ratios. Inverse trigonometric ratios like d by dx of sine inverse x, cos inverse x, etc. Cosine inverse x will be 1 by root of 1 minus x square. Then d by dx of cos inverse x will be minus 1 by root of 1 minus x square. These can also be proved similarly. Then 17, d by dx of tan inverse x will be 1 by 1 plus x square. 1 by 1 plus x square. So like this, we get this thing. Now these you have to, some more are there. You have to keep them in memory. That memory, it will come as we use them in problems. They will automatically come in memory. Only thing is, what we have to do is we have to do a number of problems. Solve a number of problems, then it becomes routine. Now this is an important chapter. You get around 27 plus 12, about 39 marks from this. Differentiation only will fetch you 39 marks. If you seriously do it, you can get all the 39 marks. There will be 39 marks in that. You can get all the 39 marks. Okay, we will take up problems in the next clip. Please subscribe and share the video clip.